What does the NFC East have to do with this offseason? Let's find out. Alright, so this format's going to be the same thing that I did with the AFC East. Let's jump right into this with the Dallas Cowboys. Now, they don't have a first-round pick because of the Amari Cooper trade. Now, the Cowboys have some cap room because they're going to have a projected $45 million in cap space, which they can use to re-sign DeMarcus Lawrence, their top free agent. But what else do they need this offseason? Well, they never really replaced Jason Witten, so they got to find somebody for him, get some help at the safety position, and get some defensive linemen to help out when they do re-sign DeMarcus Lawrence, because they're not going to let him go anywhere. And they do have some other guys that are going to be free agents. So finally, replace Witten, get some help for Lawrence, and get some help in the secondary. Now, some interesting storylines. One is, keep an eye on the offensive line. Tyron Smith and Zach Martin both got hurt during the season, and Travis Frederick was not on the field because of something that he was dealing with. So the offensive line is going to be something to keep an eye on. Another thing to keep an eye on is the receiving corps. Yes, they have Amari Cooper now, but I don't know if they have enough around him. Once teams realize what Cooper does in that Cowboys system, they're going to start to double-team him a little bit more, start to play against him better, so you got to make sure that you have enough guys to help him out in that receiving corps. And finally, what are you going to do with Sean Lee? Alright, he's been on the team for a while, but they drafted Leighton Van Der Esch, sorry if I pronounced that name wrong, to basically replace him, and he had a really good rookie year, so will they move on from Sean Lee during the offseason? Next up are the New York Giants, who, if they don't move on from Eli Manning, they are making a big mistake, because Manning, he's pretty much done at this point. He doesn't really have a lot left in the tank right now. I just don't see it in him. Now, the 6th overall pick, they're probably going to draft Dwayne Haskins, whether they stay there or try to trade up over other teams that may want to get him. But I do expect them to get Dwayne Haskins in this draft. And if they don't, well, I'd be shocked. Now, they also need help on the O-line and the D-line. The Giants' O-line has been basically the worst in the league for a long time. And yeah, they signed Nate Solder to help that out, but they still need a lot of help on there. You know, Eric Flowers, he was a bust. And they haven't really gotten any kind of production out of anybody else on that offensive line. And the D-line, they just got to find some players there. And with $27 million in cap space, that's going to help out tremendously. Now, the Eagles have a real problem here. They are over $1 million over the cap right now. They have got to figure out what players they may move on from this offseason. You could see somebody like Michael Bennett, who may not be back next year. Also, another storyline, what's going to happen with Nick Foles? What team is he going to go to? This is one that might dominate the offseason until it really happens. I'm not sure where he's going to go, but he will find a home at another team. And for the Eagles, their top free agent is definitely Brandon Graham. He's been there for a long time. And the question is, would Philadelphia try to bring him back? I'm not sure. They did draft somebody to take over for him when he did leave the team, so he may leave this offseason. Now, what exactly does Philadelphia need? Well, they need a corner because Ronald Darby is a free agent. That was their top corner from last year. Need to get a running back because they pretty much did a running back by committee last year. Get somebody that's going to be your number one running back. And get an offensive tackle. Jason Peters is getting up there in age, so they may draft somebody or sign a free agent to take over for him. And one more thing to keep an eye on. Carson Wentz's health. He came back from that torn ACL. He wasn't himself, and then he had the back issue. Can he stay healthy for the entire year? His health is going to really be the driving force behind if Philadelphia is able to get back to the playoffs in 2019. So keep an eye on that. And finally, we have the Washington Redskins, who have $20 million in cap space right now. Now, let me get this out of the way. Alex Smith, he's not playing next year. We already know he's not going to be able to play next year. It's not going to happen. So they have got to figure out what they're going to do with that quarterback position. Do they want to try to get a veteran? Or do they want to try to draft somebody and hope that he's ready right away? If I'm the Redskins, I get a veteran for that one-year stopgap. Maybe draft somebody too, because Alex Smith, he is 34. So we don't know how much longer he would have had anyway. But the Redskins need to figure out what they're going to do at the quarterback position. Another thing is, what's going to happen at the running back position? Adrian Peterson's a free agent, and Darius Geis is going to be coming off a torn ACL. Are they going to try to bring Peterson back? Are they going to try and roll the dice with Geis? Are they going to try to bring in a free agent? Are they going to try to draft somebody? I don't know what's going to happen. Another thing, the Redskins, they have got to get a number one receiver. They do not have one, and they need to find one for whoever is going to be playing quarterback. And their top free agent, for me, it's Preston Smith. He's been a really good player for them, but I don't know if they're going to give him the money that he's going to desire because he hasn't really reached his full potential yet. And one more thing, keep an eye on Josh Norman. I don't think they're going to cut him because that would create another hole, but he hasn't really lived up to the contract that he signed. So just another storyline to keep an eye on. What's going to happen with Josh Norman? All right, guys, that was the NFC East. Next up is the AFC North, and I'll see you then.